Hey there, J-Rock here. This is my first tutorial video, so I hope someone finds this helpful. For my first repair video, I'm taking on the task of repairing dead lines or dead columns on the LED display of this original Nintendo Gameboy. My brother found this when he was moving, and knowing how crazy I am for video games, especially retro consoles, he gave it to me. It was missing its battery cover, but I ordered a replacement part online very easily. I put batteries in it, and it wouldn't power on, and upon further inspection, I realized a battery leaked inside at some point. So I cleaned the battery housing and all the contacts using Q-tips that I lightly dampened with isopropyl alcohol, or rubbing alcohol. I lightly dampened the Q-tips and cleaned away any and all debris, making sure that all contacts were easily making their connection. So then I put in the batteries. Power it on. Only to find the dead pixels. See how the side of here, I had the contrast turned down all the way, so all the pixels should be black. But using my DS stylus here, you can see these lines on both sides are not connected. So I'm going to show you how to fix that here. Get that all opened up again. Batteries out of the way for now. Okay. So after I did some research online, I figured out how to do this. I think I've never done this before, but I think I'm going to be able to take care of it. First off, you're going to need a few things. First and foremost, you need a tri-wing screwdriver. I ordered this online in a kit with some security bits for Nintendo cartridges as well, but that's how the tip should look. Three sides there, a tri-wing screwdriver. Second thing you're going to need is a small Phillips or star screwdriver. And thirdly is a soldering iron. Now I've heard you could use a heat gun too, but I don't really like the idea of using a heat gun that sends a unconcentrated blast of heat over a general area of the inside of the guts of the Game Boy. I don't want to melt anything, so I prefer the precision of the soldering iron with its precision tip. Okay, now we're ready to start. Using the tri-wing screwdriver, take the four screws out of the back. They are here, 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 and here. And then also there are two in the back of the battery compartment. Now I already did this, so I didn't have to have you sitting through it all of it. So now you're going to open it like a clam from the bottom because it's connected at the top by a ribbon and you don't want to break that ribbon. You'll see here, use my pointer, here is the ribbon connecting here to here. And you want to unplug the ribbon carefully from the back part of the Game Boy, is where the port for the connection is. I don't want to wiggle that back and forth. There we go. Pretty easy. Okay, now you're done with the back half of the Game Boy for now. You can get that out of the way. What you're working on is the front screen. The speaker will pop out of that, but it just sits in there. I'll show you how to put that back in. Okay, so you want to take the screws out for the circuit board to come out to get to the LED display. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 holding it in so you can get that board out. now we're ready to lift the board out, but we want to be careful that we don't rip the connection for the speaker to the circuit board. You want to lift it out past these gray things that are holding it in. It's like Face Off, that movie, shitty movie with John Travolta and Nicolas Cage. So now would be a good opportunity to clean out your buttons. You could take those out. Clean them if you want to with mild soap and water. I'm foregoing that right now because I want to get through this repair. But as you can see, it does get dirty over the years. This was sitting in a basement somewhere for I don't know how long. And oh, look, there's a staple inside. That's good. There's a staple inside there. That's terrific. We'll get rid of that. You'll see there is a black rubber strip over this film that's connecting to the LED display. Now, use something, I'm using my fingernail, but if your fingernails aren't long enough, use something to just remove that. As you'll see, it's just kind of coming off there. Okay, also, you want to kind of scrape the adhesive that might be left over from the rubber. Scrape that. Don't scrape the film, and you want to gently pull that off. And there you have. There it is bare. Where we are going to roll the soldering iron over is this part here. Make sure everything is all reconnected. After you take off that security strip, you can reconnect the first part to the back part with the ribbon there so that you can look at your progress as you're going to make sure that you're doing it right. As you can see as I'm rolling across, the lines are lighting up. So I used some of this solder and I just sort of filled in this section here, heated up some solder and made sure that the connections were being made from this part to the screen. And it actually held, and as you can see, let me zoom out here. As you can see, every single line is hooked up right now. So, let me just get rid of the extra soldering stuff. Screen's fixed, ready to be put back together. I'll just do that quick time. Take the ribbon back out. You should be used to this. You might have had to do it a couple times like I did. Okay, now that you got those 10 screws back in, you're going to make sure that the speaker is back in. You're just going to line up that ring with the red ring here. And this isn't the red ring of death. There to just set in there. It's set. Make sure to push in both sides of the ribbon to the port. Sometimes one side gets in more. Want to make sure it's all even. There we go. Okay, and just to make sure, before we do it all back up again, we're going to make sure that it works. And there you have it. Screen is fully working. Now that you got the repair out of the way, you're ready to rock some classics from the Game Boy library. I am going to play myself some Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, and I think I've earned it. Damn, that feels good.